Hi there, and Bwana Sifiwe. That's in translation, praise the Lord. My name is Mung'ara Kimacia. I am a pastor at Crisis Dancer Ministries, and it's a privilege and an honor to bring God's word to you. I began a series where I'm encouraging us to serve God regardless and regardless of the giants, regardless of the majority report, and today we will be talking about serving God faithfully regardless of the waiting time. Because I can tell you, some of the promises of God concerning our lives and our situations, we really have to wait. And I know you have been waiting. And so welcome. May the Lord bless you. When we talk about waiting and time, I think what comes to mind is, you know, an expectant woman, an expectant lady. And that is so fresh in my mind because recently, last year, by the grace of God, my wife and I, we were expecting a baby. And I can tell you, from the time we discovered that we have conceived and the first month came, the second one, the third, I can tell you, expectation kept rising. We were hopeful. And I can tell you, the 9 months, at some point they felt like 1 year. At some point they felt like they are moving too fast. At times they felt they are a bit too slow. And I can tell you, it's amazing. Oh, waiting is not easy. And I don't know whether you're like me, majority of us, we do not love waiting. You know, you have to queue. You know, you have to wait to board the train. You have to wait to board that plane. You have to wait and wait and wait. Some of you are actually maybe waiting for your spouses to come home. Some of you have been waiting for the engagement ring. Some of you have been waiting to be asked. You know, you've been waiting and waiting. And many of the times we feel like we want to help God. You know, move time fast. You know, we are looking forward to something, and waiting is not easy. And can you imagine Caleb at 85? You know, the promise had been given when he was young. Those of you who are keenly read the word of God, remember our text is still Joshua 14, where Caleb was audacious in his faith to serve God and to ask for his mountain. Caleb had to wait for quite a long time for the promise of the land to be fulfilled in his life. And so as we serve God, we see one thing, that Caleb knew what God had said. He was courageous to deal with the giants. He was courageous, you know, to serve God and to ask for the mountain despite the majority voice. But we see a man that is patient. We see a man who learns to wait on God. We see a man whose faith is fixated on the promises of God. And so as we seek to serve God and to wait on Him, I'm here to remind us that we need to trust God for patience and grace, and especially where there seems to be delay. Can you imagine Hannah? She prayed to God for a child. Can you remember that woman who was bleeding for all those years and she had to wait on God for her healing? Remember the crippled man at the pool of Bethesda? He had to wait for God to come and heal. And I'm sure I'm speaking to people who, yes, God has spoken. Yes, God has told you, I will bless you with a family. I will bless you with a business. I will bless you with a job. Maybe you graduated in 2000. And 10 years later, you're still waiting on God for a job. You're still waiting on God for a spouse. You're still waiting on God for a child. You're waiting on God for that car, for that house, for whatever situation it is. I can tell you, waiting is not easy. And we need to trust God to give us patience and to give us grace to wait on Him, and especially where we sense there is a delay. Because the tendency is this, that because God has taken long, because God seemed maybe to have forgotten me, many of us, we go for plan B, we go for plan C, we even want to help God. You remember Sarah in the Bible? She helped God, and yes, Ishmael was born, but at the end of the day, chaos came into her family. Young lady, hold on to God. Yes, that relationship may have lasted for 6 years and there is no ring on your hand, Hold on to God. Wait on God. You're there. You've been walking in purity. You've been walking in holiness and righteousness. Please do not waste that because someone has offered you an opportunity to conceive that child, because maybe you're wondering, Lord, how will it be? And gone are the days of conceiving by the Holy Spirit. I'm here to remind someone, please be patient and do not go ahead with that plan. Do not go ahead with plan B. Do not go ahead to help God. Just tell him, Lord, I only have you. Here on earth, in heaven, everything that I am, I will wait on you. I will hold on to your promises, because your promises are here and amen in Christ Jesus. But secondly, not just trusting God for patience and grace, let's pray to God to teach us surrender. Because many of us, yes, we are waiting on God. Yes, we are on that mountain. Yes, we want to serve God faithfully, even when the time period of waiting on him seems to take long. But many of us have not yet come to that point of saying, Lord, I surrender. And I'm here to ask someone, would you ask the Lord to actually teach you the principle of surrender? This is the point where you come and tell the Lord, not my will be done, but yours be done. Not my timing, but your timing. You know, not my way, but your way. And actually the Bible tells us that like one day is like 1,000 days to God, and 1,000 days just like one day. So where you think God has delayed, maybe him, he's still on time. And I'm reminded of the song, you know, when the news came to Jesus that Lazarus is dead. You know, Lazarus was his friend. The tendency when you hear your friend has died is to run. But Jesus stayed for 3 days. And the songwriter says, you know, he might have delayed for 3 days, but 3 days does not mean denial. 3 days does not mean that Lazarus will not be raised. And so I'm here to tell you this. 3 days or 3 months or 3 years or 30 years or 30 months does not mean denial. Delay does not mean denial for someone. For we children of God, delay means that God knows what is working out behind the scenes. Delay for us believers builds our faith. Delay for we believers builds our prayer life, even as we learn to surrender to God and to wait on him, because his promises are yea and amen in Christ Jesus. And so would you learn to surrender to God's will and to God's timing, because God is sovereign. And even when God will not come quickly for you, still tell him, I only have you as my option. Please don't turn to other things. Don't turn to idols. Don't turn to other gods. Don't turn to witches and wizards. Don't turn to sorcery and divination. Don't turn to imaginations of men, but turn to the word of God and tell him, Lord, teach me patience. Give me the grace to wait, and teach me, O Lord, to surrender to you. And I can tell you, when Caleb surrendered to God, when he walked in trust, total trust and total dependence on God, then the time came, yes, at 85, to occupy the mountain. I hear someone say, Pastor, soon and very soon, I'm getting married. It's been 50 years. It's been 60 years. I hear someone testify soon by faith, Pastor, I'm expecting a child. Yes, it's been 20 years in that marriage, but the Lord has finally done it, because the Bible tells me that he makes everything beautiful in its time. And so I pray for you that you who has been hustling and walking from one office to another looking for a job, may the God who is able to beautify lives beautify yours soon and very soon, and may he give you the grace to wait on him, because soon you will have a testimony and you will say, my beautifier has taken away the pain, has taken away the shame, and has given you a new song and a new testimony. Thank you so much for watching this. Thank you so much for waiting on God. And thank you for liking and sharing this video, because I pray and trust it's been a blessing to you and it's going to be a blessing to someone. You're there, you're actually depressed, you're stressed, you do not know what to do, because you've been waiting on God and the answer seems not to be coming, there is a number appearing on your screen. Call us. We'll pray with you. We will counsel with you. And I trust that the Lord is going to encourage you. God bless you, and thank you for watching. Amen.